Welcome, everyone. This session is called Automate Your Factory Via App. My name is Dave Cameron. I'm the Director of Sales for the United States, and I work for Bosch Rexroth Automation and Electrification Solutions Division. So today I want to start with a vision. I want to start with Bosch Rexroth's vision of something we call Factory of the Future. Easy to understand, factory of the future. What is manufacturing and a factory going to be like in the years to come? So what's going to happen in our vision is we're going to have a building, right? And we're going to have an intelligent room that's flexible for manufacturing. It's going to have mobile devices. It's going to have machinery for producing products. And things are going to be able to be moved around in that factory to adapt to the changes required for the products being manufactured and built in that factory. So mobility is very key in that intelligent room, as everything is communicating within that room. And also there'll be virtual product representation. So before anything's actually coming off a production line, there will be digital representation and virtual, let's say, manufacturing going on ahead of real manufacturing. And this is the concept that we have. Bosch is a manufacturer with over 280 manufacturing sites, a large global manufacturer. And Bosch Rexroth is a global automation solution provider for manufacturing. And this concept of factory of the future is kind of the core around realizing where we're going in the industry towards a solution. And we have what's called now, next, and beyond from a viewpoint of how it plays out. So it's pretty easy to understand. We're doing things today in the now. A lot of IoT discussion going on the last few years and realization of data. The next is what we're doing with the data and, you know, how it plays into improving manufacturing and realizing that factory of the future in another step. And then the beyond is what we'll define as the autonomous, the learning type of machinery and processes that happen in a plant to yield the optimum results of that intelligent factory. So this is where I want to start with today so that we can continue the journey towards talking about solutions to get there. So what's really important in the factory of the future from our perspective is an innovative automation platform. So the electrification and the automation provided the brains of everything going on in the factory is really the essential part that we're talking about here. And so we're going to talk about Control-X automation, and we feel that's the game changer in the industry to serve as this innovative automation platform. But before we do that, we really have to think about, you know, where is it going? Automation systems really have to adapt to not only requirements for 1 year from now, but we're talking about a decade plus or a future-proof idea. And that really stems from the fact that things are changing exponentially, you know, in the world of automation, of course. And this automation platform that is essential has to be easy to use, familiar to the user. It can't be complex with all the things it has to do. And there is complexity in trying to realize this. And IoT and IT and all the things that have been discussed over the last few years in this realm, it has to be familiar and easy. An automation platform has to obviously be able to connect and exchange data easily. And that's really a lot of the now that we're talking about in our concept. So it has to do all these things. And Control-X automation, which we're going to talk about as a solution set, you know, has to realize this. So, let's look at it from now the industry standpoint. We're talking about packaging industry, and we're talking about a consumer-driven industry, heavy consumer-driven industry. So certainly I go as a consumer and purchase all kinds of products. I'm attracted to the way the products look, let's say online in a store, and I'm a consumer, as is the rest of the world, and the way those things look, the quality, the safety, the sustainability, and the packaging, the availability of those products is appealing to the consumer. So now we get to, okay, a factory has to make that. And in order to do all these changes that we see in the consumer world and all the demands that are, let's say, ever changing, have to be realized by a manufacturer, of course. So that requires this flexibility, this changeover, this transparency that happens in the production of these systems. And of course, you know, high productivity levels are always a given. And then we get to, okay, if this product's going to be made and it has to be all these things in the factory, now the machines have to do the job to help the production be realized. So we're talking about something that's, you know, let's say modular in its approach from a machine standpoint, smart diagnostics, of course, being safe, simple, scalable. So they all work together, right? From the consumer driven to the factory to the machinery that's going in the factory and all the design concepts of the machinery. So if we look at a machine example here, drilling down to the machine level, which we're going to focus on, is, you know, that has to be a machine that perhaps at one time in the past was five machines doing five different things in a production line. And now I've seen many times over one machine doing all of those functions of the five. So building a modular machine is really important, and having toolless changeover and adaptability and a intelligence to be able to make variations of in products from small lot sizes to high volume is a demand on the machine builder now. Again, all driven by the consumer that we talked about in the supply chain. So we're going to focus, which is Bosch Rexroth's business, on the automation that we provide to the component of the machinery aspect in a lot of ways today. So our answer, as I mentioned, is this Control-X automation platform we're going to focus on. And one more topic I'd like to cover before I do that is, you know, things have changed. I've been in the business 30 years, and there used to be silos for starting with mechanical engineers doing, you know, at that time, mechanical engineering concepts for, let's say, the frame of the machine, all the mechanics, all the bearing systems for things moving around and the structure of the machine, the electrical engineers doing the electrical element, software, figuring out how it's going to functionally program, and then all the parts of commissioning. And now today and in the future, that's all a digital realm. That's all 100% digital workflow. So machine building, we're saying, is really become software development in a lot of ways. So the tools have to be there in a automation platform and in a toolbox for that machine builder to realize what they want to realize quickly and effectively. So in order to do that, we have a solution in Control-X automation. And I would say on the simplest way to get started is we're going to say hello to the smartphone of automation. And the smartphone of automation is pretty conceptually easy to understand because everyone understands a smartphone. Everyone at every age level across the globe understands the concept of a smartphone. So this is Control-X automation. It's the smartphone of automation. And it really is a way to have an app-based approach, an easy way to add automation and control functions via apps. So that is something that's running on the machine, we'll call runtime apps, that are happening to make the machine produce the products. It's at an engineering level when you're doing design work, for example, in creating that machine. And it's at the service level. So as it's running that and all the automation is working on that machine, it's the management of that system that's happening. So it's an app-based approach to it in a lot of ways, which is why we're calling it the smartphone of automation. So I'll take a step in explaining what is Control-X automation. Conceptually, it's the smartphone of automation, but in the end, it's a product family that's offered from Bosch Rexroth. So you see some icons on the screen. It's a complete automation solution. So of course, it's a control, which you see in the center. It's very dependent on a control platform that can do all these things intelligently. You have to have I/O, you have to have safety, you have to have, let's say, PC-based or touch screens, motors and drives, IoT functionality, the functional elements of doing motion, such as robotics or CNC, or let's say in this realm, packaging applications to do wrapping and functional things you need for packaging machines. So it's a complete automation suite. That is Control-X automation, just on a basic level. It's products and it's software and it's a platform to do automation. And what's when we set out to produce a product line that can meet all these challenges, you know, we said, well, less has to be more, and we achieve that. That means things like smaller space and reduction of size on hardware, connection points reduced at 40% in installation, software installation being reduced 70%, less bill of materials. So both hardware, software installs all being greatly reduced. And let's look at a video that can really explain this concept in a simple way. Okay, you saw there, 40 axes in a very condensed space, for example, a lot of space savings, a lot of reductions, and we achieve that in Control-X automation. Let's now look at connectivity and communication, just to get a feel and understanding of what we're talking about in the elements being put together, let's say on a machine or in a system architecture. We have a controller central, that's talking to field devices such as servo drives, VFD drives, IO, and obviously the motors are all connected to the drive systems, all on a network shown here in this graphic, let's say running on EtherCAT as a main automation bus. Then we have, a controller that's talking to another controller or machine to machine within an assembly process or let's say a packaging line that's happening. So we have elements of machine to machine control. Then we have the IoT and IT connectivity pieces that are in this type of architecture, for example, talking to a cloud for information flow or an MES system. And then there's device management, which is supervisory of making sure that everything has, let's say, all the right apps and let's say firmwares and software versions that are all managed in this device management process. So this is a connectivity and communication viewpoint of Control-X automation that would be, let's say, pretty typical. So the heart of this, the brain of this, is really our Control-X core, which is the controller of the system that handles so much of the intelligence on the system. And you can see that this graphic shows that it's an element of the drive system. It's a standalone traditional element, like a PLC would be on a machine traditionally, or we see in the last years for sure more IPC-based or computer-based controllers. And this Control-X core is a very powerful multi-core CPU. It's universally applied to all these type of system architectures in terms of drives, standalone or IPCs. And there's really no software boundaries between these topologies. So it's very future-proofed and very scalable and flexible and consistent in the approach that the machine builder wants to take. So let's look at another video that really explains this in a simple way. Okay, great. So now that you saw how the Control-X core in principle is optioned out to different, let's say, use cases on the machine, we now want to look a little bit further. So, you know, what is it made up of? Well, it's a controller that has, you know, let's say local management of all the devices that we talked about in an automation bus. It has the ability to, as we talked about on future proof, to have 5G expansion, certainly today Wi-Fi, different Ethernet, TCP/IP connections, local backup and storage if you're if that's needed. That's kind of comes from a traditional, if there's a, let's say, a simple way to change out a unit. But there's all these connection points in which this controller can manage the system. And the first thing that everyone has always asked for years and years in the latest realm of security. And our answer is, well, of course, security is from the moment it's powered up. It's very well thought out, and it's certified according to a standard, an IEC standard. It's built upon, you know, a very great platform of Linux, Ubuntu, in the operating system. So it's already has that element based on Linux, and the security apps are there for firewall and VPN. It's integrated in the system. So security is really there in the design and from the moment it's powered up and deeply considered in the elements that are concerning, let's say, to the community over the last years. A little bit deeper on the, let's say, the inside architecture. So we talked about the session in terms of a viewpoint of apps. And so the apps is really the heart of it, which we're going to continue to talk about on an engineering and runtime basis, running on this controller that we call Control-X Core. And all the information that's happening on the system, all the variables, all the data that's in the now, and that's going to develop into all the elements of next and beyond, are there's just this data layer that is really, really well thought out in our system, and is part inherently of the system to easily manage and connect to all the different apps in terms of being able to be used. So we call this the data layer. And then, of course, I mentioned the Linux real-time, so that's part of the inner structure, and it's a multi-core CPU. So this, again, can be part of a drive system, a standalone controller, or an IPC, and the architecture inside is, of course, exactly the same and uniform. So the magic behind it is really about the ability to use these apps. So again, we're talking about apps in this session and approach to factory automation, and you can simply use a whole bunch of apps that Bosch Rexroth is providing, but even more magic behind it is the fact that you can create your own apps. You can get third-party apps that are available on the market. So apps for Python or your own developed apps is totally available. I've seen this already in the early stages of this product launch and people using different types of apps outside of what we're even offering. So of course, we're going to go a little deeper on this, but all the different, let's say, platforms of language and programming. So I mentioned Python, the traditional ones are there, but Java and Node-RED are all part of the platform, and all the tool chain are all the available Visual Studios and Eclipse are there to use as a front end. And really importantly, especially to, let's say, the younger generation of engineers is a community of support, a not only Bosch Rexroth automation community, but things like GitHub will be supported. So there's a lot of magic that makes this product very powerful and very usable and to a whole new generation of engineers to come. So device management, I mentioned, it's not only a nice to have, it really is a requirement with all these things going on in automation, especially all these IT elements and an app-based approach, just like your phone. You really have to have an easy-to-use or a device management approach, which Control-X Automation provides. So it has, you know, for example, there's things happening on your phone all the time, and some are auto updates, but some can be managed by yourself on your own. And it's no different on the Control-X Automation platform in the way it's uses device management for adding new functions and managing what's existing in a very simple way. So I will now state, you know, in the ControlX automation platform, it's really the most automation, open automation system on the market. That's our claim. How can I say that? Well, let's look at the center. There's over 30 communication interfaces that are supported on this product line. I mentioned EtherCAT, all the standard open protocol Ethernet-based buses. TSN is already designed in, which is time-sensitive networking that's available and beginning in the early stages that we'll see in the automation platform. So a very large ecosystem of communications. I mentioned it speaks all languages, so flexible enough to be able to have programmer A building a machine who prefers, you know, Python, and then, you know, let's say machine builder two likes the traditional IEC 61131, which is fully supported. Machine builder C or number three wants C sharp for their type of application. It speaks all languages. The same functional things can be realized in all these types of language approaches to program the system. And of course, the industry 4.0 languages, MQTT, OPC UA, are also native to the ControlX automation system. So flexible and expandable that you see on the graphic is even one more level of powerfulness of the system. So integration of user IP, open source software is completely available to the machine builder and the designer of the system, which is really makes it the most open automation system on the marketplace. And I covered some of these. We took care of security on the design. What I didn't mention on the cloud connectivity, for many years, we've been able to connect to all the standard cloud platforms, Microsoft and Oracle and AWS and MongoDB, for example, SQL Server. So we support anything that's, let's say, cloud-based and open system connectivity for the data collection, data monitoring. And it's also localized, so you can support ed server communication and do things locally as well. And then there's all the management that comes with the device management and the taking care of all the updates and security patches that have to happen. So it is really a unique IoT integration approach to automation. We also call it the revolution in engineering. So why is it the revolution in engineering? Well, one key point is everything we've done on this product line has a digital twin. So we can do a complete virtual control for the engineer designing a machine, never has to have hardware, and can develop, you know, taking this ControlX core and simulate everything on the machine virtually, can do a virtual representation, a virtual control of how that control is going to be used and how the machine can be developed virtually through this digital twin idea. So of course, it's a web-based approach. So really just plug in and there's no software, it's all web-based. So using the ControlX core is just as simple as using your browser, and everything is really browser-based. That's kind of expected, I think, in the world, but it's really powerful in not having to manage all the software that's required over the last few years to do such automation. So also the no and low code, we could have an engineer take an approach with Blockly that I'll show you an example of. Complete wizards and very, very minimal coding is also an option. Last point is collaboration. I mentioned, you know, the whole nature of today's generation of younger engineer is going to use all the tools, App Store, YouTube, online manuals, web-based configurations, use a community of GitHub that I mentioned to be able to do the function of their job and figure out how to get this machine done in a quick way. So it really is a revolution in engineering using ControlX automation. Now for the end user, I talked about the whole chain. Now the machine's running, designed, and an important element, especially to the production or the factory level, is how am I going to keep this machine running and be able to run it for many years and have it adapt, like we're talking about, to so many different things that may change on the machine. Well, the good news is Bosch Rexroth has always been best in class in providing very long life of our products. Very typically, our products are 25 or 30 years available, and Control-X Automation is no different. So we'll have a long, let's say, open design life and an extended service life for that machine to keep running, and, you know, services to keep happening. In the Control-X Automation platform, because of the nature of the product and everything we talked about here today, there'll be a lot of service apps available to manage the system. There'll be a whole, let's say, integrated condition monitoring that's available. So there's a whole tool set on the service realm that will help after the machine part is designed and the end user wants to take care of it in their factory. I talked about a lot of stuff here, and I hope you got the picture of the powerfulness of Control-X Automation. And really, when we design this system, then all the elements I talked about, we're really talking about unlimited possibilities. The creativity elements of such a toolbox and such on this platform, Control-X Automation, is really powerful. So many elements of automation can be realized, even with OEM versions and taking, you know, representations of the control onto different platforms from the Control-X core standpoint. Getting to a point of AI computing interfaces and doing that beyond step in the years to come with AI is totally thought into this product line to be realized. So it really is what we're calling a platform of unlimited possibilities. Let's look at an example. Now that we've talked about the product, let's put it into an example. So robots are everywhere, and especially a lot of the trade fairs of many years recently. Every time I've gone to one, I see more robots, more robots, more robots. So let's use a robot example in packaging market. So a Cartesian is something that's supported, you know, today from this platform. And we have such a great solution for an XYZ in 100 millimeters or 4 inches of width, these servo drives can fit in such a small space. So there's that example I talked about of having minimal space for, let's say, efficiency and floor space, reducing the floor space that's needed for a better machine footprint. Let's drill down now. Now we talk about the approach or the coding, even something like Blockly, a new language, a new low code approach that an engineer wants to take for a Cartesian system is part of the system that they can use. And it's something that was never part of the past, but it's one of the many open platforms that we are allowing people to program in for realizing, for example, a low code approach to a Cartesian system. Python is another one that's come up. I've already seen, let's say, a few customers that would like to use Python right from the first meeting, and this is available also as a low code freedom of choice to have the engineer comfortable with what they want to do instead of trying to force them to a training and learn a language they're not familiar with. Let's use, you know, what they want to use, such as Python, because they were schooled in it or they have experience in it, right? Now back to the app element of it. So smart features are part, for example, of an app library. So we have a Cartesian system. It has this, let's say, long Z axis. And now, you know, the system as it extends has a vibration on the end of it. So vibration dampening is something Bosch Rexroth's always had as a function. Now it's an app in the system that you choose, along with potentially some hardware interface that allows you to get rid of that dampening that's happening on that Z axis. But it's now an app approach to how you would take care of that on the system. And IoT Insights is an app that just really gives you analytical data and gives you a window into what's happening on this Cartesian system in an, let's say, an app environment or a visualization to see what's going on in the system in a very simple way. So there's some of the smart features from an app perspective. Okay, a lot of product talk. So that everyone can understand how this automation platform can solve the things I started with in the realization and pursuit of what we see as the factory of the future. But in that, I'd like to also state you know, the realization across the value stream is really important. So myself as a sales manager going in, always have to present, you know, why is it a better product and how does it solve problems for a customer that I'm talking to? And, you know, it's pretty apparent, I think, from the presentation that we can realize with ControlX automation a lot of steps in the entire value stream. So in the machine design, which I heavily focused on today, all fewer components, virtual engineering, comfortable engineering, which could be save a lot of time for the engineer programming in their language. The app-based approach, which is a very simple way to do things, really results in a very effective machine design. You know, the elements of less cabling and, you know, that build and test cycle gets reduced with information, for example, as well. Then we have to ship it out, we have to install it, and we have to get it into production. And then we have tools to keep it in production and makes even, you know, improved production over time. So I can tell you for sure that ControlX automation as a vital component, which I spoke about in the beginning, will really save across that value chain to realize a lot of these things. So as I'm getting to the end here, I would just really like to go back to the now, next, beyond, and circle back to the factory of the future. So we talked about the fact that we have this vision. We created a product to meet the vision. We know where the market is going, and it's going fast. And we really created a powerful product to realize at the machine builder level, which translates to now to the manufacturing level to satisfy the consumer. And if we circle back, and that now is what's been happening, as I mentioned, we have this built in the product, so we can get data. Everything's digital, everything's connected. In the next, what's happening is now we're doing something with the data, and we're forcing better machines and better results. And then, you know, what's happening in the next phase that we see is really this autonomy. So we know edge servers have been around. We know that we have autonomous abilities in other parts of our life, like cars, but it certainly is going to be part of the factory. And these elements are all part of the vision, and we're working on so many things, and there's so many pieces of ControlX automation that's going to help realize the beyond that we're after for really this factory of the future. So with that, my final words I would say is, you know, ControlX automation is two steps ahead. That is our claim. It's really the most innovative platform that's out there to realize all the things I talked about today. And you can get more information online by visiting the website that you see there, www.controlx-automation.com. If you have any particular questions for me, you can find me on LinkedIn, Dave Cameron, Bosch Rexroff, and I'd be happy to answer any specific questions that you might have that you want to address to me. So with that, I want to thank you for your attention. Hope you found it interesting, and thank you very much for attending today.